The Novena to St. Alphonsus Liguori.
Hello dear brothers and sisters, and a warm welcome to the second day of our global online Novena to St. Alphonsus. A big shout out to our confreres, sisters and lay partners in the mission all over the world. Today our reflections will be on the theme of St. Alphonsus as an artist and musician for the good news. It will be led by Father Kevin O'Neill, C.Ss.R. Father O'Neill has been a Redemptorist for 46 years. He has experience in parish pastoral ministry and has a PhD in Moral Theology from our Alphonsian Academy in Rome. He has also co-authored a very popular work introducing us to the moral teachings of the Church titled The Essential Moral Handbook and has been teaching Moral Theology. Since 2013, he has been on the preaching staff at San Alfonso Retreat House in New Jersey, USA. Today, as our confrere preaches on Alphonsus as artist and musician for the good news, it's interesting to note that Father Kevin studied piano and has a love for music. He finds it a wonderful means for preaching the gospel and reaching the hearts of people. Now for the opening hymn. Day 2. Acquire the habit of speaking to God as to the dearest and most loving friend. Dear St. Alphonsus, you have said, acquire the habit of speaking to God as if you were alone with Him, familiarly and with confidence and love, as to the dearest and most loving friends. Intercede for us, that we may grow in prayerful union with Christ our Redeemer. The Daily Novena Prayer. Saint Alphonsus, friend of the poor and herald of the good news of plentiful redemption, journey with us as we seek to become spirit-filled missionary disciples of Jesus Christ today, especially to those who are marginalized in society and the Church. You are the doctor of prayer. Teach us to pray unceasingly. You loved the Eucharist. Teach us to draw ever closer to Jesus in the Eucharist, in order that we may be food for others on their journey. You were devoted to the Passion of Jesus Christ. Help us to accompany those who suffer and who walk the way of the cross in their daily lives today. Through your preaching and writing,
you gave people a greater knowledge and appreciation of the divine truths. Accompany us as we explore the great truth of the mercy and love of God, and to share this with those we meet along the way. You loved music, art, and the beauty of God's creation. Help us to see beauty in the world and the people around us, and to care for creation, particularly earth, our common home. God of love and mercy, you continually build up your church by the lives of your saints. Grant us grace to grow in faithfulness to our given vocation in life and to follow Saint Alphonsus in his loving concern for all people, a concern that bore fruit in action. Walking in the footsteps of this devoted servant of yours, may we be filled with a desire to spend our lives in joyful service of the most abandoned, whether they be in our own homes, our communities, our church, or our world. We ask this through Christ our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
I begin with two brief passages of Scripture, from Psalm 150 and from St. John's Gospel, chapter 3, verse 16. From Psalm 150, praise him with trumpet and sound, praise him with lute and harp, praise him with tambourine and dance, praise him with strings and pipe, praise him with clanging cymbals, praise him with loud clashing cymbals. Let everything that breathes praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And from St. John's Gospel, for God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. These two brief passages of Scripture offer a background for our theme today, Saint Alphonsus, an artist and musician of the good news. The only thing that we could add to Psalm 150 is praise him with paint and brush, praise him with pen and ink. You know, St. Alphonsus could meditate for hours on these brief lines from St. John's Gospel, that God so loved the world that he gave his only Son. It was Alphonsus's own heartfelt sense of God's love that not only moved him to love God in return, but to try by any means to tell others of God's love. And today we focus in particular on Alphonsus's use of art and music. Like many children of the nobility in the 17th and 18th centuries, St. Alphonsus Liguori's education included training in art and in music. And while his skill could have simply been a badge of honor to point to his family's social status or something to impress people about himself, Alphonsus used his talents in art and music to preach the gospel. And he did so in a very creative way. He used the arts to reach poor people who could not read, but who would see his art distributed at parish missions, or they would sing his music, learning the depths of God's love for them in the process. When St. Alphonsus preached in the 18th century, there were some spiritualities of his day that presented God as distant and not overly concerned with the people of the world. God was seen as one whose majesty required people to grovel before him. Yet in response to these spiritualities, St. Alphonsus spoke of a God who was crazily in love with those people, whose love was unreasonable, a God who drew near to us. St. Alphonsus once put these words on the lips of God: as long as I have loved myself, I've loved you. As long as I have been God, I have loved you. In other words, I've always loved you. But Alphonsus also conveyed this message through his art and his music. For example, in one sketch, Alphonsus presents Jesus like this pudgy little Neapolitan baby. And in this sketch, Jesus is fishing for hearts. What a far cry from a distant or a vengeful God. Not only does Jesus look like a cute Italian baby that people might have seen in their own home or next door, but this baby Jesus is looking for us, fishing for our hearts. Similarly, Alphonsus's images of Mary make her look like a poor Southern Italian woman. In one image, Mary wears the hat of a shepherdess, and Jesus reaches out to sheep, seemingly playing with them. People could relate and speak to this Jesus and Mary in their prayer, because they would identify with them through Alphonsus's artwork. Also, at a time when there was a great emphasis in some circles on the limits of the grace of God, that salvation was only for the few, Alphonsus preached the plentiful love of God, plentiful redemption. His words and his images told the poor who were used to being left out, who experienced a scarcity of the goods of this world, that there was no scarcity of God's love and grace for them. In a painting of the crucifixion, Alphonsus painted this when he was only 23 years old. The arms of Jesus seem a bit elongated, as if Jesus is trying to stretch out his arms to embrace all who would come to him. This painting of the crucified Jesus might startle us with all the blood on the body of Jesus. Realistic, I'm sure. But Alphonsus wanted people to see how much God loved us, that no suffering was too much because of God's love for us. So Alphonsus's artwork was done not to hang in museums, but to be seen and to live in the imagination, especially of the poor, but of all of us, so that we might know God's closeness to us, that we might know God's love for us, and that we might lift our hearts and minds in love of God in return. And it also, you know, it wasn't only with his artwork that Alphonsus preached a God of loveliness. He used music to teach and to raise the minds, the hearts, and the voices of the faithful in prayer and in praise of God. The lyrics of the most popular Christmas song in Italy to this very day were composed by St. Alphonsus. Listen to a few lines from the song "Tu scende dalle stelle," or "You come down from the heavens."
Tu scendi dalle stelle, o re del cielo, e vieni in una grotta al freddo e al gelo, e vieni in una grotta.
The people who have sung this hymn for well over 200 years have sung of God's love for them. The lyrics read, "You come down from the stars, O King of the heavens." At the time of St. Alphonsus, the heavens were viewed as this place of perfect order, and yet God doesn't stay there, but rather he comes to us. How does he do so? The song continues, "And you come in a cave, in the cold, in the frost. Oh, my divine baby, I see you trembling here. Oh, blessed God, how much it costs you, dear chosen one, little infant, this dire poverty. This makes me love you more, since love made you poor now." Love made you poor now. So the hymn tells the story of God's love, the love that moved God to become human in the person of Jesus. But not only does Jesus come into the world, he comes to us. St. Alphonsus had great devotion to the Eucharist. And in another song, "O fiore felici voi," or "O you happy flowers," he offers the image of a person standing in a church where the Blessed Sacrament is exposed in a monstrance on the altar. And the peasant sings of how happy the flowers on the altar are because they're in the presence of Jesus. And then how happy the candles are to burn there in the presence of Jesus. Then how lucky the monstrance is to hold Jesus. And then the singer says to the flowers, to the candles, and to the monstrance, "But how much happier than you when my beloved comes full of love into my heart." What a consolation this song would be to anyone who thought of God as far away. To sing of a God who longs to dwell in our hearts. I don't know of your experience, but it is certainly mine that sometimes music touches in the heart the ways that words can't. In one and the same instance, these songs of St. Alphonsus tell us of God's love, how precious we are to God, and they move us to sing back of our love for God. In Tu scendi dalle stelle, Alphonsus says that seeing God's poverty and becoming human makes him, Alphonsus, love God all the more. And Alphonsus hopes that we will do the same. What is your experience of hearing the good news and praying through music and art? Is there a particular work of art, religious or otherwise, that moves you to love God? That helps you realize God's immense love for you? What music opens your heart in love to God? Is it a hymn or some other song with lyrics, or simply an instrumental piece that stirs your heart? I remember the Mass of Christian Burial for my mother over 10 years ago. We processed up the aisle singing, "Be Not Afraid, I Go Before You Always. Come, follow me, and I will give you rest." At a time of deep grief for my family and me, that music and those words brought great comfort and moved me to praise and thank God. Comfort because I heard those words as spoken to my mother. "Don't be afraid. I'm with you. Come and rest." And they moved me to words of thanks to God that she was at peace. I think, too, of a man I knew who battled addictions in his life. And whenever I asked him how he was, he would say, "Better than I deserve." He said that there was one song that described his journey and his relationship with God. "Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found. Was blind, but now I see." That hymn told the man's story of sin and grace and redemption. A grace and love that were stronger than any transgressions in his life. The great English Jesuit poet Gerard Manley Hopkins once wrote that earth is charged with the grandeur of God. Isn't that true? There are signs of the love and the presence of God all around us, in nature, in literature, in the goodness of one another. So many ways in which the divine touches our hearts in surprising and unexpected ways. A beautiful sunrise, the birth of a child, the last words of a loved one, all of which might move our hearts to a deeper sense of the presence and the love of God, and move us to lift our hearts in love as well. Saint Alphonsus, the preacher, author, artist, musician, and doctor of prayer, opened his heart to be filled with the plentiful love of God and sought all means possible to convey that love through his preaching, art, and music, as well as through his writings. And he did so in order that we might know God's love and raise our voices in love and praise of God. Alphonsus's creativity with art and music ought to encourage his sons today, the Redemptorists, to read the signs of the times and to seek similar creative ways to preach the gospel, so that it might reach those on the periphery, those to whom they are sent, those who might not appear in churches, but might come across their efforts at evangelization through social media or through other means. It requires an attentiveness to the times in which we live and how best to respond and to preach. As baptized Christians, we might all follow Alphonsus's example and preach the gospel through our own words and actions, perhaps through art and music, or whatever means are available to us, all so that we might witness to God's boundless love. In these days, we honor Alphonsus for who he was, but more importantly, because through him, through his words, through his art, and through his music, he allows our hearts to be touched by the God of loveliness and offers us ways to return God's love through prayer and to witness to God's love and share it with others. Saint Alphonsus Liguori, pray for us.
Prayer of Petition. Dear Saint Alphonsus, obtain from the heart of Jesus, our Redeemer, the graces necessary for our spiritual and temporal welfare. I recommend to you in particular this favor. Saint Alphonsus, pray for me and those I love. I have great confidence in your prayers. I earnestly trust that if it is God's holy will, my petition will be granted through your intercession for me at the throne of God, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Saint Alphonsus, artist who used your gifts of imagination and painting to express your tenderest emotions toward Jesus Christ and his mother, pray for us. Saint Alphonsus, musician whose religious lyrics and melodies are sung to this day, pray for us. Saint Alphonsus, you have said, whoever says this little canticle from the heart causes joy in paradise. Let us pray. Jesus, my true, my only love, I wish for nothing but you. Here I am yours, my God. Do what you will with me. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Dear friends, thank you for joining us for day two of our global novena to St. Alphonsus. Tomorrow, Father Larry Kaufman will inspire us with a reflection on St. Alphonsus as a friend of the poor. Do join us for day three of the novena. It will premiere tomorrow at 6 a.m. Indian Standard Time. Now, the final hymn.
See Alphonsus-Sat
to love you.